After 4 years of the stages, best-selling author and singer Adele made a reappearance. For those of you who have been living under a rock and have never heard of Adele, she is an Oscar-winning British singer-songwriter who has sold millions of albums worldwide, won a total of 15 Grammys, and has a staggering net worth of $190 million. She's also an inspiration to many self-starters and a reminder of just how much their hard work can pay off. So in today's video, millionaires, we're going over how she made her money and how she's currently spending it. You won't believe how much she has paid for her properties, and even more impressive, the fortune she paid for a playhouse for her son. So stick around. Let's begin by understanding where she comes from and why she is where she is today. Adele Lori Blue Adkins was born on May 5, 1988 in North London, England. She was the only child of Penny Adkins, who was just 18 at the time of her birth, and Welsh father, Mark Evans, who left the family when Adele was very young, at the age of 4 years old. Her father's departure left her mother in a difficult financial position, but she managed to make it work as a single mom. Her mother's determination to provide the best life she could for Adele ultimately created the environment that serves her so well during her formative years. If she'd been stuck providing for herself from a young age, the songwriter just might not have had the time to develop her craft. Fortunately, young Adele had more than just space and time. She also possessed an immense passion for music and singing. She began singing at the age of 4 and became obsessed. She spent much of her youth in Brockwell Park, where she would play the guitar and sing to friends. Adele made her official debut as a singer and up-and-coming pop star at the age of 18 years old. In 2006, she uploaded 3 demos to her MySpace page, among them her first song, Hometown Glory, and managed to sign her first contract with London record label XL. This took place after just 6 months from her graduation from college. She performed in many places, was featured at many award events, and sold more than 120 million albums. Even now, 13 years after the initial release, they continue to sell well, providing Adele with an ongoing source of significant passive income. And to this day, these albums keep making her incredible amounts of money. But before she made it as a millionaire singer, Adele began her journey in 2008 when she released her debut album, 19, while working for XL Records. She supposedly made $10 million that year. Adele not only released her Grammy award-winning album, 21, which won her 6 Grammy Awards in 2011, but she also managed to make $15 million that year. Then in 2012, she followed this huge success as she released Skyfall for the James Bond movie of the same name and won 3 awards for it, an Academy Award, a Grammy Award, and an Oscar. By December 2012, the singer made a whopping $18 million. She took a 3-year hiatus, but the sales didn't stop as she made a combined sum of $100 million in 2013 and 2014. Expectedly, the money never stopped coming as Adele released her 3rd studio album, 25, in 2015. She was met with an incredible welcome back and made a ridiculous $60 million that year alone. If $60 million sounds like a lot, you're in for a surprise. Keep watching. In 2016 and 2017, she toured to support her album, 25, and made a mind-blowing $252 million in ticket and merchandise sales combined. Adele is the company's sole director in charge of her tours and personally took home $74 million from the $128 million the company profits. That comes to a mind-boggling $685,000 per night she performed. This led to Adele earning yet another $40 million in the years 2018 and 2019. Now in 2021, Adele continues to rake in millions for her new studio album, 30. Her current net worth is estimated to be $190 million, an amount that is sure to grow as the earnings from her latest album accumulate. Of course, Adele is just as adept at spending her money as she is at making it. The singer spent much of her first $1.35 million advances from XL Records shopping and purchasing cosmetics. Now that she has almost $200 million, the recording artist has also purchased several real estate properties. In 2012, she got her first home in Sussex and paid $3.5 million for it. She purchased this 10-bedroom mansion early on when her career began to take off after the success of her first album. As the home is called, Lockhouse takes up a massive 20,000 square feet of space and has 5 reception bedrooms, 2 studies, and a helicopter pad. Later on, she listed it for sale, and now it has a market value of $8.9 million. And this is just the beginning. Keep watching. Following Lockhouse, the award-winning singer purchased a luxurious Art Deco house on the beachfront in Hove, outside of Brighton, for $3.5 million. That same year, she bought another property, a flat this time, in Kensington for $7.8 million. As if all this weren't enough, in 2016, the millionaire singer got herself a Beverly Hills mansion for $9.5 million. This lavish property boasts 4 bedrooms, 6 bathrooms, and features a pool and summer house. After Adele and her husband, Simon Konecki, divorced, Adele decided to stay close to her son, Angelo, and bought the property neighboring her old Beverly Hills mansion for $10.6 million. But the A-list singer didn't stop there. She bought a third property in Beverly Hills with 4 bedrooms, 4 bathrooms, a pool, and a basketball court, costing her $9.5 million. It's in close vicinity to her first Beverly Hills house. But million-dollar properties aren't the only luxuries that the Hello singer spends her money on. She also indulges in high-end cars and wears expensive luxury brands. In 2013, the singer was spotted by paparazzi at the Porsche Center in Chiswick, where she ordered a custom-built $100,000 Porsche Cayenne 4x4. Despite being an SUV, the Porsche Cayenne 4x4 feels more like a sports car with its low driving position and smooth steering. As you might imagine, the singer doesn't hold back when it comes to style. She gets the expensive help of the very talented fashion stylist, Gael Paul, who she pays $27,000 a year to prepare her for red carpet events. The iconic singer also spends thousands of dollars on high-end labels. She wears $500 Linda Faro sunglasses, $700 Christian Louboutin heels, and $4,000 Burberry and Chanel bags. And when she needs a new look, Adele gets the help of celebrity hairstylist Lino Carbosiero, a 57-year-old British hairstylist of Italian origin who currently works for the well-known Daniel Galvin Hair Salon in London. Carbosiero has clients under the names of Sharon Osbourne and David Cameron. Adele also hires makeup artist Michael Ashton for key events, costing her up to $13,500 a year. The singer's $190 million net worth made her capable of purchasing a $20,000 playhouse for her then 18-month-old son, Angelo. It came with a veranda, 3 turrets, electricity, and its own picket fence. Being the big star she is, Adele cares greatly about her safety, and she employs a professional security team to keep her and her family safe. When paparazzi manage to get photos of her, it's often with a bodyguard close to her side. It's also been stated that Adele has hired Lady Gaga's bodyguard, Pete Vanderveen, who cost her $94,000 a year. So that's how Adele spends her $190 million fortune. She definitely came from a difficult environment, but managed to follow her passion and get the life she knew she deserved. Make sure to watch our video on how Kim Kardashian spends her millions. It comes as an incredible contrast to Adele. So, what do you think after watching this video of millionaires? Are you feeling inspired? And are you even more motivated to follow your passions now? Let us know in the comments below. And as always, don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already. Until next time, keep rolling in the dough.